Krishna explains how his devotees perceive this world in the Bhagavad Gita. He's saying, this is how a devotee becomes dear to him, or a devotee who is dear to him has these attributes and these qualities. In the 12th chapter, Krishna is saying, anapeksha hashuchir dhaksha udasina gatavyataha. Anapekshaha, he is indifferent, neutral. Sometimes may success may come, sometimes failure may come. He is indifferent. Anapekshaha, shuchir dhaksha, udasina. Udasina means also don't bother. Udasina gatavyataha, and no distress touches him. Because he has understood all this material world, happiness, distress, is like the perception of happiness and distress of a madman. What is this big deal? So, udasina gatavyataha, sarvalamba paritya. A devotee who is not dependent on ordinary course of activities, who is expert, pure expert, without cares, free from all pains, and who does not strive for some result, is very dear to me. So, udasina becomes indifferent to this material world of happiness. For the materialists, this pursuit of happiness is so big, so important. Their whole life they are giving to that. And a devotee realizes this is just meaningless. Now, so this is how a devotee, a yogi, sukha dukkha bahya, he is outside of all these, he's not perturbed by these things, sukha dukkha bahya, udhasina. Now, this is how a transcendentalist, a devotee, feels. Now, it's very interesting, Krishna describes how he feels about this material world. The Lord is also watching this material world. Someone is glorified, got the best actor, Oscar award, this, that. And how is the Lord watching that happening? All those kind of events that are happening, politician getting elected and this and that. How is the Lord looking at that? Krishna describes that in the Bhagavad Gita. Nachamam tani karmani nibadhanti dhananjaya udasinavadasinam asaktam teshu karmasu. Krishna's attitude towards this also, udasinavadasinam. How is Krishna situated, looking at all of these things, all happening under his direction? Mayadhyakshena suyate, prakriti suyate, sacharachara. It's all happening under his direction. But he's udasinavadasinam. He is also indifferent to it because it's just a play. Sometimes parents watch children and they're doing some, you know, with the toys, something, and some in their game, something has become success and everyone is happy there. Some of the one doll's birthday, they are celebrating, children after all. And then they're happy, this is this child's birthday, this doll's birthday. What do parents look at? Udasina, udasina. Children after all. There's no birthday, there is no nothing, it's just they are playing like that. Udasina. Now, very interestingly, Prabhupada explains this in the Bhagavad Gita, in the purport of the Bhagavatam. Different perspectives of the world exist, right? That's what people say. Oh no, that's his perspective. This is his perspective. This political party has one perspective, another political party has another. All these kind of different perspectives people talk about. Philosophers have perspectives. Now, Prabhupada says, Krishna consciousness or the Krishna conscious perspective is the same as the perspective of the Lord. Imagine this world of plethora of perspectives. Everyone is having different, people are having different perspectives about the world and how they look at it. What is this universe? What is happening in this world? How we should act? How we should not act? These are all relative perspectives of so many people. There is one perspective the Lord has, and that perspective is the perspective that we learn in Krishna consciousness. And we see that how the devotee, the Lord is udasinavat asinam. The devotee is also about the material world, udasinam.
Hare Krishna. Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss any updates.